In the previous episode, we covered the use of graph state variables and used the variable switch nodes to switch between different shots. We are now going to make overrides on a per-shot basis using those tools. Once we've gotten past the first merge after the variable switch, what occurs in the node graph will occur in every single shot, but sometimes we might want to make a change on only one shot. When we switch to those shots, so 100, 120, 150, we can see that our renders are not coming out as expected. This is because the wall is actually in front of the camera, so we need to remove the visibility of the wall on these three shots. We could go into each of their groups and edit this on a per-shot basis, but that would not take advantage of a multi-shot workflow. It's best to make this change in one place, so if we want to modify it in future, we only do that once. First, create a variable switch, link it to a dot node. Remember, the keyboard shortcut is full stop. And in the variable switch parameters, type in our variable shot. Now, there are multiple ways to access your variable values. One way is to type in a string that corresponds to the variables. So in the second input, you can enter the three shots in a string. So 100, 120, 150. This means that any shot that is true for this input will go down the branch on the right-hand side. We can see this by switching across the variables. Remember, if the nodes are dimmed, it means it's not being read in the node graph. You can also use expressions. If you want this node to be true for all the shots, you can type in an asterisk symbol. Obviously, this defies the point of using a GSV in this case, but you can use this to subtract values to it. So asterisks minus 0010 will be true for all shots apart from this shot. The question mark symbol can be used to replace characters. So typing in 00 question mark 0 will make this true for values 0010, 0020, through to 0090. In this case, we only have three shots to modify, so we'll input these values in the form of a string. So on the right-hand side, let's place in a DL object settings. Every renderer that has a plugin for Katana gives you the ability to alter settings per object. Place the path for the wall in the cell statement, and within the visibility group parameter, untick visible to camera. Now we can see our scene for these three shots. You can also do this with a variable enabled group node. This is basically a conditional group. If you input the variable name and the values, it'll only go through the group when the GSV matches the values. So it's up to you whether you use a variable switch or a variable enabled group, but they do similar things. The main difference is how it's displayed in the node graph. We now know how to make overrides on a per-shot basis. This kind of operation is useful for maintaining multiple variants of an asset or lighting setups. Next, we will look into cell and collections to set up render layers.